Love is one of the most powerful words known to man. So let's talk about why love empowers you and why love beats hate. And let's start right now. What is up, my winning friend? My name is Zach and welcome back to another video. If this is your first time here and you want to reach your potential and crush your goals, start right now by hitting subscribe and tap the bell notifications. That way you don't miss anything. My mom is one of the most loving person that I've ever met in this world. She went out of her way to express love to me and my sister all throughout our lives. And it didn't just stop right there. Everybody in the community that we grew up in Ferguson, Missouri would say the same that knew her. She went on to create the Ferguson Youth Initiative in Ferguson, Missouri after my sister passed away from a heroin overdose and spent the last 5 years of her life dedicating herself and serving that community to help bring it together and help serve the young people in that community. And before she passed away from stage 4 lung cancer. And I remember we took a trip out to Arizona to see our relatives and to see our cousin get married around Thanksgiving time. And I remember, you know, at the time she was already on hospice and on all these medications that made her like literally loopy. And she could barely get around, could barely walk. She was at the very last stages. This was actually 2 weeks before she passed away. And I remember me and my uncle and my cousins, we went out to In-N-Out Burger, which is like the thing out there in Arizona. It's not here in Missouri. And we ate an In-N-Out Burger, and I took a bite of this hamburger. It was like 2 or 3 bites in, and I cracked my tooth, and it shot like a huge pain. I had this tooth pain that was just unbearable, but when I took a bite out of it, it was so bad. I mean, it hurt so much. I literally put my burger down and walked to the other side of the house to the bathroom next to the room that I was staying at my aunt's house. And my mom noticed that, and she was in this pain already. Like, she could barely even get around. And she made her way, and she was limping all the way over there to the bathroom and came in. And she didn't even remember stuff half the time, but she came in and said, "Are you alright, honey?" You know? And I remember, you know, seeing her, you know, make that effort and showing her strength just to go out of her way to make sure that her son was okay. You know, that's unconditional, man. And it just enlightened me and empowered me, you know, just by her showing that act of love and act of kindness just to come and see if I was okay, even though she was suffering way worse than I could even imagine at the time. What you love empowers you and gives you strength to do things in life. But on the flip side of that, what you hate and what you fear literally cripples you. So if, like, for instance, a lot of people don't like to see other people succeed. It's like a sheep mentality. They like to, you know, if they see somebody else succeeding and doing something extraordinary with their lives, it gives them a feeling of failure because they're comparing themselves to them, and they don't like to see other people succeed. And that's a sheep's mentality. They think that if other people are having success, then they can't. When really the abundance mentality says that everyone can have love and happiness and success. And when you have those feelings of hate or envy or fear towards other people, it literally cripples you and holds you back from your potential into achieving the things that you want to in life. Growing up without a dad, I always wanted to fit in with other people. I wanted to be accepted. I used to fear people's opinions of me so much that if they had any negative opinions about me, that would cripple me. I wanted to fit in and be accepted so bad. I guess I was looking up to the wrong role models or looking up for father figures. I don't know what was going on, but I just wanted to be accepted by other people my entire life. And this led to depression, and eventually I started using drugs, and that eventually led to me catching cases, which led to me going to prison. All the while, I had good intentions in my heart, and I love other people, but I had this flaw of wanting to be accepted so bad. And during my 2-year stay in prison, I started to want to fit in with all the cool kids in prison, all the bad guys, and putting on this fake persona because I wanted to be accepted so much. And I remember when I was in the hole and I lost my sister to a heroin overdose. The hole is the prison inside of a prison. So I was already in there, and I just realized that I lost my sister to a heroin overdose. Got a 30-second phone call to my mother, and that broke me down, you know, for 3 days, just in just a horrible state. You know, I was praying and crying and just looking for any sense of hope. And over time, while I was in the hole, I built this routine that helped empower me. You know, I started cleaning my cell every single day, doing this workout and reading the Bible that, you know, flooded myself with scriptures. And towards the end of that, I found a peace of mind in a very dark place. And when I got out of the hole back into general population, where you can go outside and do activities and stuff like that, I just started looking at things in a different light. I started appreciating every single blessing that I had. You know, while most people in there were complaining about the guards being petty, the rules, the weather, the living conditions, whatever, I was looking at every single thing as a blessing that I had three meals coming to me each and every day, that I was able to go outside and enjoy the 90 to 100 degree weather outside and see the birds flying and just appreciating nature. And I was loving, you know, everything about that. And I began to love myself. And what that did for me, I can't even explain in words, because I no longer from that point on needed the approval of someone else to feel good about myself. I no longer had an urge to fit in with the cool kids and the bad people inside of prison. I was able to be a man, you know, stand on my own and be happy with that. One of the best things that you could do is to look for things to love in the world, especially today when there's all this hate and violence that's dividing us instead of bringing us together. Look for things that you can love and appreciate and be grateful for. If there's people or things that you hate or envy or just don't like, stop looking at those things that you don't like about someone else or something, and look for the things that you do like and that you do love and do appreciate about them. And what that does is you're expressing gratitude, and it brings people closer together instead of dividing them apart. And it empowers you to, it opens you up to accept more happiness and more success from the universe. Of course, you're gonna have to take actions on your dreams, but by loving and putting out these feelings of gratitude and these great emotions, you literally open yourself up to receive more blessings. Try to understand people for their differences. Don't just judge them because they are different. Put yourself in their shoes and try to just feel how they feel and try to understand them. The most powerful thing that you can do is to spread your love throughout the world. Whether other people accept it or not, just by putting it out there, you're gonna get it back. If this video helped you in any way, shape, or form, and you wanna watch more videos about love or just effective living in general, then check out this playlist right there. Share this video on Facebook, and if you have any friends or family members that you care about and that you love, share this video with them as well. And if you want to reach your potential and crush your goals, start right now by hitting subscribe and tap the bell notifications. That way, you don't miss anything. Thanks for watching. See you next time.